So we're using the women's basketball data, and they are certainly like open to using this tool when we build it. But I think what we're trying to do is build something that's more generalizable and can be applied to, you know, any team that would like to have their game footage analyzed and have their player positional data extracted that way. It's been a puzzle, and we're still in the first part, the data extraction part. We haven't even started building the model yet. Internally, our stakeholder is, you know, the professors, the Data Plus program. But if we really want to think about how this technology can be applied, we have to think about who can use this tool if we were to build a tool that is capable of doing this. So we kind of think along those lines of three different stakeholders. It could be, you know, coaches, it could be an administration, or it could be players as well. And those three stakeholders we have to think about when we're trying to deduce what's the point of identifying these plays. From a coach's perspective, they can determine how well their offense and defense is adjusting to specific plays drawn up by the opponents. From a player's perspective, a player can watch their positional data and see how are they responding to a defender as they execute their offensive plays. For our purposes, we're kind of using computer vision for image segmentation. So we're identifying players on the actual game film. We're using pose analysis, so we're tracking key points on the player's body, so like their knees, their shoulders, to watch like how they shift during specific plays. And then if you want to go back towards like those classical techniques, we're actually, we're taking the camera's perspective and we're mapping those player positions onto a two-dimensional court, right? So we kind of have to warp the perspective of the camera to understand where the players are relative to the actual like top-down view of the court. So yeah, so I think we're taking a lot of different approaches for computer vision, but essentially we're taking game footage, we're taking images, frames of a video, and we're extracting data from that. I think what we're building here is typically something that would be proprietary to, you know, like a higher up team, like an NBA team. But you know, if we can build it and make it more democratized to other teams and give them access to these tools, that would be, you know, a pretty good outcome for this project, I think.
And it is cool being the only undergrad and like getting to learn from people who have a lot more experience than I do. The idea that the assistant coach had was, since he was manually inputting all this stuff, he wanted to create something that was more focused on like play identification. And so being able to take, you know, just an entire game's film and put it into some sort of machine that could then break it down and say, okay, you know, at this point there is with turnover, or this player made a three-point shot. And so that was his idea. The project manager's idea was more like almost like a chat GPT like system, where you could say, okay, like here's the information we have about Duke, here's the plays that they normally run, like can you design a play using the video data, and maybe taking that even a step further, like design a play when Duke plays UNC or something like that.
It's shaping the way I think about cameras and perspective and lighting as well. All of those have such a huge impact when you're trying to, you know, extract data from like literally the pixels of each frame. So I think, yeah, the positioning of cameras, how that can affect how players are perceived by the camera, and then also just kind of like, you know, if you don't have a camera in a position that you want it to be in, you can still warp the frame to create what you're interested in. And that's kind of been an interesting part of working with cameras and videography.
Once we actually get things up and running and like being able to actually look into the plays and specific things, I'm very excited for that.
Basically, you know, like nowadays, there's a trend of like AI doing sort of a human job, like ChatGPT. So our big goal is try to have like sort of a ChatGPT for basketball, so that it could be applied into any type of task that a lot of coaches want it to do.